Good afternoon. This is Jim Lakey with news announcements for St. John and Maxville, Kansas, here on Cable Channel 3 and SandylandCenter.org, our website. And today is the last Friday of the month, Friday the 29th of January. And here in the square at St. John, it's sunny and 57 here at noontime. And we're looking forward to a great day today. The high temperature should be 61, and the low temperature only 30. So this is a really great day, one of the best days in weeks. And Saturday and Sunday are probably going to be really nice as well. Partly cloudy both days, Saturday and Sunday. 59 the high on Saturday. 50 the high on Sunday, and on both days they're around 32 for the low. And then something that happens, and of course we're always glad to get moisture, and on Monday and Tuesday we're expecting to have rain and snow. So depending on which side of the line you're on when the storm goes by, we have a 90% chance for rain or snow on Monday and an 80% chance on Tuesday. And and the temperatures, it'll be 39 on Monday and 26 the low, so probably it'll be mostly rain, and they're predicting maybe 1 inch, while on Tuesday, the high temperature is 29 and the low is only 14. And so we'll probably have from 1 to 3 inches of snow instead of rain. And then we have sunny weather again on Wednesday, but it isn't going to warm us up much. The high temperature will be 33 and the low 14. So enjoy the weekend this weekend, because they're going to have another cold spell after it's over. And we wish to say happy birthday this weekend. Nick Garcia, happy birthday today. Laura Rodamo, happy birthday Saturday. And Andrew Meters, happy birthday on Sunday. We hope that you enjoy your birthdays and you've got good weather for it, as opposed to anyone whose birthday is going to be on Monday or Tuesday. Well, I'm kind of speechless in a way, which is unusual for me, about some of the things I hear about how the Dillon store closing is going. And I've heard rumors that the Dillon store plans to keep its lease for about 2 years more and put nothing there just to keep us from being able to put in a grocery store to take the place of theirs when they close. And I can't believe anybody would do that, so that could be just a rumor and maybe it's wrong, but I do want people to know that Mark is looking to gather information and working on a special broadcast with some of our technical folks here, with Ron and Mark, and they're going to try to have a special instead of the regular news on Monday. So tune into the news on Monday at noontime or 6:30, and we hope to have a special that summarizes everything that can be found out up to date about what's happening with the Dillon store and what sort of things are going on, and perhaps some of the plans that the city has to be able to look for another store. And we'll be doing that here on Channel 1, Channel 3, as often as we have other news to let you know. So we hope that you will tune in to our news broadcasts and look on the internet for announcements. And of course, the news broadcasts themselves are on the internet at SandylandCenter.org, and you can see the news and the special broadcasts, even if you're not a subscriber to the cable system. They're there on the internet. So stay tuned, and we'll try to do the best we can to keep the internet updated and our news broadcasts to bring you the latest and the most important and perhaps some of the best ideas that we hear about what to do considering we're not going to have a grocery store. Well, let's go on. We have happier things happening besides losing grocery stores. So this Sunday at the church, St. John the Apostle is having their special pancakes. And so at the church, whichever one you go to, or even if you don't go to one, go to the St. John the Apostle Church, and in their area connected to the church, they're going to be having pancakes, and you never get anything bad to eat at the church. And churches here are really great. Sometimes I think that keeps us from getting as many restaurants as we might have because the churches always have such good food. Well, here we have at the Sunflower Center, Monday they're having their potluck dinner for seniors for the month, and that's February 1st is Monday at 6 o'clock. And they would like people to bring a couple of dishes to share. So that's an important announcement. And then it's hard to keep track because some of them have changed. And they have changed this one. This is the Lunch Bunch. And they're going to the barn in Burton. And they're going to go on the 5th. And so that trip is $7. They leave, they didn't say when they, it looks like they leave at 11, and they may stop at Yoda Cement Ornaments to see what they have when after they have lunch or before it. The cost is $7. And the rec commission is 549-6549. Then Friday the 12th, the seniors are having a Valentine party, and they're having coffee and dessert. It's at 1:30 at the Witt Senior Center, otherwise known as the Sunflowers. And they're having a game called Valentine Bingo with prizes. So this is a good thing to do. And then the Dodge City Casino trip had been changed now. Instead of February 2nd, it's going to be February 23rd, and instead of going on a tour bus that you have to go to Great Bend to get to, it's going to be with the, in the ad they say the rattly old bus. So the St. John bus, and it's going to leave at 8 and come back, leaving Dodge City at 2:30 and be home at 4. And it's $10, so the casino trip will be similar to what we always have. And unfortunately, I don't have the menus yet for next month, so all we can talk about are the menus for Friday. So here at the Sunflower Center, they'll be having baked turkey patty and cooked cabbage. And at the VIP Center in Maxville, they have a choice of breaded baked tilapia or barbecued meatballs and a baked potato. And so you can't ask for better things than what are at the fellowship meals. And we hope all the seniors will support those. Those are good to have. And since we're not going to have a grocery store, maybe more of us will be going to the fellowship meals because we forgot to go somewhere else to get groceries. Well, this is a hard thing for us to get used to, using our grocery store. And we'll try to keep you posted here Look at the bulletin board, look at the internet to see the various things that Mark has been diligent and Carol in copying and taking pictures at all the major events. Well, the word of the day is this: no matter how often we say money doesn't bring happiness, we're always willing to give it another chance. This is Jim Lakey, hoping that you have a great weekend.